in my opinion.
And now it's her American teammate, Riley McCusker, who is the one American in the field today for the women's all-around in England. McCusker, part of this nine-woman field, and 17-year-old from New Jersey. What do you expect from her?
Well, she has great ability. There's no question about that. Was part of the 2018 world team for the USA that earned a ticket for the team to the 2020 Olympic Games. She's tremendous on bars and balance beam. Was actually eighth in the all-around at Worlds, but didn't get to advance because there's a maximum of two gymnasts per country, and that was Simone Biles and Morgan Hurd.
And there is also a seven-time Olympic medalist in the field here as well.
Unbelievable. She is such a champion. She's the reigning Olympic champion on the uneven bars and the Olympics before that. Took a little bit of time off, had a baby, came back, and is looking better and better.
And now up first on the vault, it is the American Riley McCusker making her season debut here in Birmingham, England.
And you know, just a few minutes ago in the warm-ups, she did the vault she plans on doing, double twisting laid out Yurchenko, and did not make it, came up really short, put both of her hands down. She certainly wants to avoid that. This is not her best event, really just needs to survive here. Oh boy, and you could see that right from the beginning. Came onto the table and had what looked to me like bent arms, little bit and very wide placement of those arms. And because of that, she doesn't get the rebound off of the table. Body doesn't really rise enough. Looked almost exactly like that in the warm-ups, as I said. Couldn't make the adjustment. Also, doesn't have what's called an open shoulder angle. When her hands hit the table, her arms should be completely over her head, and they're not. She kind of collapses onto the table, and that is a recipe for failure.
Now trying to get the nerves out of the way here in her first event of the season. Really had a bounce back year last year after an up and down 2017 campaign that wound up ending with an injury. Last year, she was impressive at the U.S. Classic, finished second overall, and was third in the all-around at the U.S. Championships back in 2018 as well. As we get a look at the judges here and a lengthy delay. And now Riley McCusker trying to representing Japan, overcome that tough start. As Nagi Kajita is coming up next.
And I believe she won't do the same vault. Will only do with a full twist, much easier. And boy, she barely got that around. Just not a lot of power on that.
Debut last year, which represented Japan at the 2018 World Championships.
And going back to Riley McCusker, 13.133 was her score. Again, a weight from the judges there.
Really low landing. Has to take a very deep knee bend. They deduct for not just moving your feet, but how you land. And that squat will cost her. It also starts from a starting point in the score potential, 4/10 less than we just saw, or actually 8/10 less, excuse me, from Riley McCusker.
Operator safely under your belt. She helped her team play six.
A little bit rough of a start for both of these gymnasts here. Riley McCusker has some really tremendous stuff coming up, though. She's phenomenal on the uneven bars, gorgeous on balance beam. A wonderful dancer on floor as well.
There it is. The score is in
And 13.033 the score for Gogeta. So two athletes in, and now Francis, Caroline Edoui, European junior bronze medalist on the uneven bars from last year.
A lot of these gymnasts just want to get through vault. Much nicer vault, though. Lots of flight. Pretty good.
So underway from Birmingham, England. A rough start for the American Riley McCusker in her first apparatus of the day on the vault, trying to bounce back as we get things rolling from the World Cup. The score for Caroline Edoui of France. And 13.366.
Nice job. Had some pretty good power. Just needs to upgrade her difficulty, certainly.
Here is Lu Jiyu, the 16-year-old from China. The Asian junior gold medalist on the vault from the 2017 championships.
And once again, that same full-twisting Yurchenko, somewhat of a basic vault. And I'll tell you what, if I were her coach, I would say, you got to run faster than this. A little bit off to the side, as you see. Both feet hop to the out-of-bounds area. But really, if you look at some of the top gymnasts, they are moving much faster down the runway. And if she wants to increase the type of vault that she does, add another half turn or a full turn even, which would raise her maximum score by 8/10. Technique is actually pretty good, but needs to move faster down the runway.
Now, last year at this very same World Cup in Birmingham, England, was seventh in the all-around. Comes from the interior of China. Very rural area in a landlocked province. But emerging at a young age to get that gold medal at the Asian Junior Championships again 2 years ago, and now at the World Cup here today. Just north of 13 on the vault.
But like Riley McCusker, she has some great events, bars and beam, certainly coming up.
Well, Aliya Mustafina, now 24 years of age, from Russia, the seven-time Olympic medalist, two-time gold medalist, and the last non-American woman to win an Olympic or World Championships all around. And that was way back in 2010. That's how dominant the American women have been over this last decade.
Same vault we saw from Riley McCusker. Good run. Oh, really good bounce off the table. Makes that easily. Has been battling with an on and off knee problem. But really pretty darn good vault. Good speed, as I said. Nice rebound from the table. In the past, she's been able to land a little bit better. But this is actually head and shoulders better than anybody we have seen thus far.
Yeah, that was a great start.
Just a little bit of form in the air. One fairly big step and then a really small one, maybe 4/10 off for the landing. Has a good body position as she's meeting the floor.
Well, she has a young daughter, Alisa, now, who will turn 2 this June. And Mustafina, still going strong at the age of 24, her score of 14.366. She is the new leader early on the vault in England. And our next competitor. Here's the 21-year-old Canadian from Quebec, Victoria Wu.
We just saw Aliya Mustafina, and Victoria says that she is her role model. What an opportunity to get to compete alongside her. Popular vault today, the full twisting laid out Yurchenko. Done pretty well. Nice power. Good arms back on the table. Pretty good rebound. Certainly capable of doing at least another half turn. Maybe a full double twist on this is possible. I'm sure in training she's is working on that. She said she watched Canada at the 2008 Olympic Games. And she fell in love, and she said ever since then she had a huge desire to represent her country in an international event.
And speaking of her idol, Mustafina, how often do you get to compete side by side with somebody that you grew up idolizing, trying to model your particular game after, so to speak?
No, absolutely, and it's a very small competition, just a couple of handfuls of athletes, so not just during the meet, but in training every day. I'm sure she certainly got to watch her as well as, you know, maybe make a little bit of a friendship.
Well, big round of applause because Ellie Downey is from England, from Nottingham. So competing in her home country here at this World Cup in Birmingham at the age of 19. British national all-around champion as well as a vault champion for England.
Whoa, baby. That was amazing. She was able to stay on her feet, did the more difficult double-twisting Yurchenko that we saw from Riley McCusker and Elias Mustafina. But watch at the end here. She scoots her feet way underneath. Her hips go way in back of her heels, which makes it very difficult to not fall down. Super quick reflexes, that really quick hop backwards was essential, or she would have sat that down and lost over a full point. Winning that national all-around in vault and floor championships just recently, she said afterwards, "I couldn't have been more happy. I've really worked hard to get back, and this is the first time I've managed to bring all my skills together in a competition." She's a tremendous athlete. And the score is very important for Team GBR.
Comes from a big athletic family. Her sister Becky, who was 7 years older than her, also an Olympic gymnast. Went to the games in 08 as well as in Rio in 2016. And it was 2016 where Ellie Downey also made her Olympic debut. Now here is Thais Fidelis, the 17-year-old. The Brazilian competed at the World Championships a year ago, was seventh in the team event.
Also a powerful athlete. Only a full twist today, though. Certainly she is capable of doing more than that. Maybe just wanted to get a good start, which it absolutely was. You know, that Brazilian team at 2018 Worlds, they were seventh, as you mentioned, but going into their last event, they were right on the cusp of potentially winning a medal. They had fall after fall on the uneven bars, unfortunately. Valeri Lukin, coach and dad of Olympic champion Nastia Lukin and an Olympic champion in his own right, is now the head coordinator for Brazil, travels down there monthly for training camps.
So her score coming up here at 13.566 for the Brazilian.
She has uneven bars up next. And oh, look at that. She's got a big rip on her hands. She's getting a little medication to try to, I'm sure, dull the pain. And she's just telling herself it that'll work. Not.
Now, the good scores help dull it the most. So Riley McCusker of the U.S., not her best vault to get things underway, and currently in sixth place after the first rotation. The seven-time Olympic medalist, Mustafina, the Russian, on top early as we get things underway from Birmingham. It is on to the uneven bars after the vaults with Mustafina leading the way after our first rotation in Birmingham, England. And the warm-up's underway. There is Riley McCusker trying to bounce back from a subpar vault, but all smiles here in her season debut. And Nagi Kajita, who is ninth after the vaults, is first up on the uneven bars, the 18-year-old. Comes from the southwest of Tokyo. Made her world championships debut last year in Doha, was sixth with the Japanese team in her first major international experience. Always good to get that first appearance on the big stage out of the way, get the whole experience, take in the environment, and know what to expect going forward.
She started with a very big release skill. Handstands are pretty good. The judges are so critical. Release here again. Nicely done. Oh, boy. And that's a shame. You know what? From the beginning, though, just doesn't have enough speed to get over the bar. Her overall body tension or tightness is a little bit lacking. And that makes a lot of things more difficult. It also, you know, increases deductions, but obvious to most. But, of course, a fall from the apparatus is a full point off.
And then just trying to get back into the routine to re-engage, also mentally difficult.
Very nice Stalter work. Stalter with a full twist. Oh, boy. That was very low landing on that dismount. Doesn't get her whole body flipping well at all.
It's a shame. Just shows how important that timing is. Just some hands on there, the wrong side, Becky.
The Japanese men have long been dominant in the sport of gymnastics, but look at this landing, chest completely on her knees. Surprising that she was able to even keep that on her feet. But the Japanese women, though, have been on a very aggressive uptick. Their star, Mai Murakami, was a world champion on floor exercise in 2017 and was second in the all-around to Simone Biles in 2018 at the Worlds.
And here is Frances Caroline Edoui, the 15-year-old at the European Junior Championships just last year, was on the podium finishing third on the uneven bars, one of her big strengths.
Very difficult to do those skills where you put your feet in between your hands on the bar. Good fight there. There's another one right there. Nice combination down from high to low. And I'll tell you what, that is a long way to travel when you are short in stature. From that low bar to the high bar. Very impressive work. Double front. Step on the landing, but overall, very solid routine.
Now she calls this her favorite apparatus, and you can see why.
And she swung really well, a small gymnast, but good lines.
Yeah, that was a very clean bar.
Nice routine, or release from low to high.
Different entries of skills, and within this routine.
Just a lot of different type of elements going on. You see that, where she scooted her feet in between her hands and the bar. Those are called inside stalter type elements. Can be a little tighter as well, though. Some body position weaknesses, but overall, a very nice routine. She says her best quality is that she's physically muscular. I agree. Stubborn, you gotta be, and determined. Showed it here on that routine for sure.
The trifecta of qualities that pay off in a sport like this. So the 15-year-old from France, a score just south of 14. She's into the early lead. But coming up, Aliya Mustafina, the two-time Olympic gold medalist on the uneven bars. And she'll be on the bars in Birmingham when we come back. Russian Aliya Mustafina has 7 Olympic medals in her career, 2 of which are gold, both of those coming in the uneven bars, which she is about to begin here in Birmingham, England.
And this is an opportunity for her to even distance the pack further. Has a lightness to her on this event. Great handstand right there. This is an awesome combination right here. Back up to the high bar. Very tricky to pull that off. Another release right here. Beautiful. After all she has been through, makes it look too easy. Wow. Tremendous, tremendous job. She's capable of doing a little bit more, which when the time comes, she will do that. But watch this combination. Pack salto right into that transition. Maloney with a half turn. Or Van Leeuwen. Very nice. Jaeger salto done with her legs together, which gives her additional bonus points, as does that dismount done in combination. Capable of doing a 1.5 twist on that, which I'm sure we'll see when the bigger events roll around for her.
Now she's a 12-time medalist at the World Championships, but last year's event in Doha, the first World Championships she has competed in as a mother. And she gave birth to her daughter, Alisa, back in June of 2017. So entering a new phase of her career, of her life. And a good performance on her best apparatus here, the uneven bars. And she holds the lead for now.
She had a big number on vault. That was a very big number there.
And our first look at the German, Leah Greaser, the 20-year-old. Did not qualify for any of the individual finals at the World Championships in Doha last year. Third on the uneven bars at the German National Championships a couple of years ago, so has been on the podium in this event.
And Germany has a lot of tremendous bar workers. Beautiful front flip, release skill. Her dismount, double front. A little bit too much rotation on that. Handles it well, though. Pretty close handstand, actually maybe a little bit past. Certainly will be up to 3/10 of a point off on that. She closes her angle in her shoulders at the end of these pirouetting skills, which the judges are looking for. That one was awesome right there. Dead on handstand connected to that release. Double front. A little bit too much height. Rotation on that. Glad she was able to find the ground there, because that could have turned out a lot worse.
So, sigh of relief there. after the routine for the German, as her numbers are about to come in. Mustafa now, still the leader, waiting and watching as well, as Greaser's score, 12.566. She's into third place. And Riley McCusker, the one-time U.S. Uneven Bars National Champion, getting set to go on the bars in Birmingham as we continue. Victoria Wu of Canada needing a 15.067 to take the lead here as we proceed through the uneven bars. The 21-year-old from Quebec was third after the vault, and now trying to improve upon her standing here.
Looking for great handstands. High-flying releases. That handstand very past. That'll cost her a little bit, certainly. Release right here. Oh, wow. Clips her heels on the bar. Dismount here. Double laid out somersault. Good recovery, but not only will hitting the bar cost her a sizable deduction, but it's smarts too. Right here, just a little too close to the bar. Wasn't the best angle to see that on. But overall, the level of difficulty in this exercise, not at the same. You see her feet hitting the bar right there. Really nice double layout. Just can't control that landing perfectly.
Well, part of a gymnastics family, as she gets the score of 12.033. Her younger sister has also competed for the Canadian national team as well. And now here is Ellie Downey again, the homegirl from Nottingham, England. So the English fans behind her here. We saw the rousing applause when she came up for the vault earlier.
And she was part of the most successful British team ever in 2015. They got on the podium as a team, won a bronze medal. Oh, boy.
Not the start she wanted.
That's too bad. She just mouth to her coach, should I do it again? Was supposed to travel over the bar. That's too bad. Here's that skill, no problem there, but way shy of the handstand that time. Big release. Another one right here, and not even close.
Crowd trying to rally her, but two big mistakes makes it extremely difficult.
Way away from the bar, didn't get her legs above her head quite high enough. Let's go with the bar a little too early. And typically, that looks like it might really hurt, but typically it's not that bad. You can kind of hurt your elbows or shoulders if you hyperflex them. This is a shame, though, because this is a really potentially great routine for her. Nice combination right there. Well, it's been a long time.
Now she got through it.
Yeah, she did. It was a very good fight, certainly, but with two major falls, Long time since she's going to get a score like she's going to get now.
Yeah, Bob's one of those pieces.
Very challenging combination there. A major release on the high bar and then another release from high to low. A little bit shy of that handstand. Also, it's the commentary's critical because that's exactly what the judges are doing. They are looking for anything that is just a millimeter from perfection.
Well, she is the European all-around champion from 2 years ago, and at the time was the first British gymnast, male or female, to have won that prestigious all-around title. Prior to that, made her Olympic debut at the Rio Games in 2016. And now from England, competing at home in front of this big crowd in Birmingham. Not going to be a score that she is going to want to see, but it's going to pop up momentarily here. 10.500.
Ouch. Yeah. Yeah. You see the shake of the head. And the worst part about it is she has beam coming up.
And that's going to be very tricky for her. But up next here on the uneven bars, the Brazilian, Thais Fidelis, a 17-year-old.
And she was honored by the Brazilian Olympic Committee in 2017 as the Brazilian Gymnast of the Year. A little bit too close to the bar on that release skill. Ooh, that one was kind of far. Didn't get the rotation she wanted to, but deals with it well. Nice high-flying releases. Very popular to see that half turn at the end of a bar routine. Giant full. And her dismount right here. A double tuck. Couple of little steps. But that's a very easy dismount. I'm sure she's capable of more than that. Nice releases. That pack salto, the flip from the high bar to the low bar, supposed to land close to a handstand. So many athletes nowadays are doing, you know, releases from low to high and high to low that, you know, just a handful of years ago, only the very best in the world could pull off.
Now the 17-year-old comes from the southern part of Brazil. And part of this Brazilian team that was in position to get a medal at the World Championships last year when several faltered on the uneven bars. In fact, three different gymnasts faltered on the uneven bars, and as a result, they finished out of the medals. So 12.233 will take us to the American Riley McCusker, coming off a subpar vault in the opening apparatus here in Birmingham, but she is the U.S. national champion on the uneven bars from 2 years ago. And then, Tim, last year just missed a national title once again by one-tenth of a point on this apparatus.
Representing the United States of America, you see that 15.6, that would move her ahead of Aliyah Mustafina. Don't think she's going to get that number, but she is fabulous here. I believe this is her best event. But it's really tricky because she'll try to do a bunch of things in combination. Right here. Major release, connect it down, and sometimes she will connect it to this skill right here. She'll just lose a little bit of bonus for that. Has a beautiful line, very tricky dismount right here. Nicely done. Needed to just slow down a little bit on the landing, bend her knees, and stay down a little bit, but that's much improved. That dismount, it has given her nightmares at different times. Very difficult. Former world champion Fan Yilin does the same one. Pretty good handstands. Then swing to this release skill.
Good work from Miley McCusker.
Like I said, nice combination here, and sometimes goes right back up to the high bar. Has to do a kip cast there. But here is this dismount done from what we call an inverted giant. Just bend your knees, stay down there, Riley. But a beautiful, gorgeous routine, actually.
Now this is her favorite event, and it really showed there. Seemed to enjoy herself, solid.
Her coach right there, Maggie Haney, also the coach of the great Olympic champion, Lori Hernandez, who is talking about a comeback as well. She was a silver medalist on beam and team gold medalist. Once again, here's that dismount, very intricate, done from somewhat of an awkward grip called an inverted giant. Does a half turn, front flip, and then back flip out of it.
Now Riley McCusker from the Jersey Coast, the 17-year-old into second place, a score of 14.400. So halfway through this World Cup event in Birmingham, England, two events down, two still to go, with the Russian, no surprise, on top of the standings. Back in Birmingham, the second largest city in the UK, where after two of four rotations, it is the seven-time Olympic medalist, Aliya Mustafina, who has the lead over the American Riley McCusker, who has moved up into second place. Well, Morgan Hurd and Sam McCulloch go for all-around gold in the FIG World Cup from Tokyo. Make sure you tune in to the Olympic Channel on Sunday, April 7th, for full coverage. Morgan Hurd coming back in Tokyo, where she hopes to make a big statement in 2020 in that same city.
Absolutely. Tremendous athlete. World champion in the all-around 2017. It was a surprise to many, not to her. A really tough competitor. Had to settle for bronze at the most recent world championships in the all-around, however. But a very important part of Team USA, as is Sam McCulloch, five-time national champion. The rub on him has been that he can get it done in the States, but not internationally at the major events. He got that monkey off the back at the 2018 World Championships with a high bar bronze medal. Fell short in the all-around with a mistake on high bar. But he has a very bright future going forward. Very competitive gymnast.
And now it's on to the beam in Birmingham with the Frenchwoman Caroline Adouet, the 15-year-old, up first.
Nice mount, round off back handspring step out. And you mentioned 15 years old. Oh boy, very nice combination right there. She's 15 now, but the only way she's eligible. Oh, jeez. And off the beam. Too bad. The only way she's eligible to compete in a competition like this, a senior competition, is if she turns 16 in the year of the competition. Oh boy. Whew. That was a great fight right there.
Her birthday is December the 2nd. Now she's got a while, but she does turn 16 this year.
And it's actually a very big break for her. She's got a good birthday there because she's eligible to compete in all these senior meets the year before the Olympic Games to hopefully gain the experience that you need the dismount remaining here. Very challenging. Good fight on the landing. Super hard. Ground off back handspring into that double somersault done in the pike position or leg straight.
After the uneven bars.
Very nice mount.
And the mount, difficult beginning to her routine.
This is a great combination. Side aerial right into a back layout step out.
Yeah, that's a really nice quality step
but
routine.
Surprisingly, on one of the more basic elements, a back tuck, and a really good fight right there, I'll tell you. She's tumbling like she's on the ground, which is just wonderful to see. A couple of little tiny steps on the women's side. If it's less than a meter, it is 1/10, more than a meter, 3/10. Those were all less than a meter.
And her score 11.6 on the beam. And coming up next, Aliyah Mustafina. But let's first take you back to her performance last week in Stuttgart at the last World Cup.
She actually ended up 5th in the competition. Beautiful combination right here, but just off the beam on an Anodi. Let's watch her foot as it makes contact with the beam right here, just a little bit off to the side. And a little bit is a lot too much on balance beam.
A European and world champion on the beam. And the leader after two rotations here on the World Cup in Birmingham.
These leaps are more challenging even than the acrobatic elements. Her series, a little bit off on that, an adjustment. Certainly, really hard. Double turn, and she's off. Last week, she did that easily. So much more difficult to do that double turn than it looks. Another little balance check. So last week she fell. Oh, and right there, kind of pulls up, doesn't do the connection she was hoping to do. Last week she fell on the Anodi, took that out, but still goes for the double turn, which is probably the most challenging other element in her routine in a competition. Practice, it's really easy to do stuff like that. Dismount here. And a nice landing, but I'll tell you what, with that fall and that full point that will be deducted from her total, that opens the door for Riley McCusker.
Beautiful style in her movement.
Now the first real bobble we've seen from the Russian here today.
Look at those toes. Boy, can she wrap those things around the beam? They develop unbelievable strength in their feet. Little bit off on that. Another look, once again. And here is where it came off for her. Looked pretty good. Maybe came out of that double turn a little bit too early. Double back, small little step, 1/10 of a point.
So after Riley McCusker did not start off all that well on the vault, she needed an opening, and now she has one from Mustafina. With an uneven performance on the beam. With her score coming up here, 11.866. So Riley McCusker in second to this Russian after two rotations now has an opportunity with her beam still to come. This is Leah Greiser, the 20-year-old German.
Leah Greiser
leads 14.900 to take the lead.
Nice mount there. Much harder than it looks. Try that at the edge of your coffee table later on tonight. Just leap up there.
Given my glass coffee table, I'll take a pass. Thank you very much.
Oh, boy. And Beam has been just brutal. Tell you one thing. You know, the British, they put on a show-like event for their gymnastics competitions. It's lit like a theater. And I don't know, personally, if I had to compete like that, it would have been a problem. You know, sometimes the spots get in your eyes. You get large shadows.
And you can see just from this point of view how dark it is. How does the lighting affect the gymnast?
Yeah, when I first saw this done at a competition, I thought there's no way they can do this. And they do, though. They put on a great event. There's no question about it, but a lot of people not a fan of the lighting from a competitive point of view. Haven't seen that in a long time. That's a Valdez. Right into a back handspring to a laid out 1.5 twist. Watch this here. Nice jump to a split. That back leg isn't exactly locked, but layout step out. And, you know, that's funny because that looked to me like it was going to be okay. Maybe she doubted herself at the last minute. You doubt yourself. You start making adjustments before you even hit the beam. And that can knock you off, not the actual flight of the aerial acrobatic. Dismount, back handspring, step out.
Still has her best event coming up, the floor, to end things today in Birmingham. Bars and floor where she really excels.
But if you've been watching a lot of World Cup gymnastics, much of it, like Jade Carey in the last World Cup this weekend and this weekend as well, that is part of the Olympic qualification procedure. You can actually qualify to the games from those individual apparatus. Not in the all-around this year. Next year, yes.
11.300 for Leah Greiser. Yeah, it is very interesting that these all-around World Cups have no bearing on the Olympics for 2020.
No, they don't. And, you know, it's a brand new thing that they have bearing at all.
Competitor on beam representing Canada, Victoria Wu.
So for the athletes here, less pressure. Maybe the ability to go out and perform more freely and not tighten up as much as they would knowing that an Olympic berth would be at stake.
It's a very popular mount nowadays. Talked about how Japan has really been doing well. France, also Canada as well. They were fourth as a team in 2018, just 0.7 of a point out of a medal. And that bronze medal went to China, of course. Double turn. She handles it easily. That was with authority. She had extra energy, did 2.25 basically. But Canada really anchored by Ellie Black, who was second in the all-around in 2017. They have a number of tremendous athletes. 2.5 twist.
Victoria Wu, the 2.5.
Well, there you go. She stayed on.
Confidently through. She really attacked that routine.
A step in the right direction.
Not easy when not just the last person before you, but so many have fallen on the beam. That back dive to a handstand, nicely done. So I mentioned Canada was fourth at the last World Championships. The top three earned an automatic berth for the team aspect for Tokyo 2020. At the next World Championships, the next nine teams outside of the United States, Russia, and China will earn their ticket to Tokyo.
Gymnast, your warm-up starts now.
Nice leap combination. Really was a very confident routine. 2.5 twist, a little bit of legs apart, you see, and the step, but overall, excellent job.
Now the 21-year-old from Quebec, Victoria Wu. We will see her scores as we continue. We'll also see the American Riley McCusker, who has a chance to move up the standings and potentially challenge for first place. The numbers for Victoria Wu, and she comes in with a mark of 12.6.
They have been brutal on beam as well. Pretty good routine for a 12.
Now Riley McCusker needs a 13.066 to take over first place. Now she did not start off well in the vault, bounced back on the uneven bars, and now the beam, really a key event for her as she looks to battle for the lead.
And she can get the job done here. That 13-plus number is very doable for her. A little bit wambly on that first wolf turn. Second one was perfect. Be surprised if she stays on the beam, if she does not move into the lead. Layout step out and completely off.
Bronze medalist on beam at the U.S. Nationals last year. Was second the year before.
Whoa, and another stumble. That series she was way off, not even close. Very big dismount combination here. Two back handsprings. Into a double top. That was very nice. Was given an opportunity, but couldn't capitalize there.
Such a flexible gymnast, very well prepared. Beautiful extension in her lead.
Well, the 17-year-old from New Jersey. Rough start here. Trying to finish strong, though.
Yeah, that's too bad, I'll tell you. This first turn looked good from that view, but got a little bit funky halfway through. Nice combination right there.
Beautiful extension of the ankles here.
Now here is the sequence where she came off.
Now, Tim, again, this is her season debut. How much is that coming into play, do you think?
You know what? To be honest, I know that if Riley is here, she was prepared to go out and do a great job. She is a phenomenal athlete, gorgeous and artistic, But sometimes she struggles with the consistency. I think that'll be a challenge for her entire career.
She was third in the all-around at the U.S. Nationals last year. And in her first event on the World Cup here in 2019, after her third rotation. Long wait for her score on the beam now.
Had the highest score of anybody on the uneven bars, but that's too bad.
Well, she stays in second behind Leah Mustafina.
And final competitor on the beam, representing
and
Japan,
now Nagi Kajita, the 18-year-old from Japan, growing up in a city just southwest of Tokyo, which will host the Olympic Games in 2020.
Oh, my goodness. Wow.
Never expect that.
Yeah, you know, I don't know if I've ever seen a final with the athletes at this level where there were this many falls. I mean, it can happen on beam, and it can be like a little bit of a virus. You know, everybody is falling, and it, you know, it can fray on the nerves for some, for sure.
How much are the others watching their competitors versus just doing their own thing and not necessarily knowing that others have fallen?
Well, it's very different. Some people like to watch and look at their own scores and the scores of others, and some people don't look at it at all. But every gymnast on the floor today knows when somebody comes off the beam. They, even if they're not looking, they hear the crowd. They know that there's a pause in the routine. So they're very aware of it. Some wonderful work, though. Took the risk with that mount. And a 2.5 and just barely keeps it to her feet. Death by beam today.
And mistakes from start to finish. I mean, from just mounting the beam to right at the end and everywhere in between.
Yeah, way off to the side. I mean, there wasn't even an opportunity to try to make an adjustment. And there also, I'm sure she wanted to connect these elements together. Has nice lines, good knees and toes throughout the exercise.
So, our last competitor on the beam, and they're probably all glad to see it in the rearview mirror now. Not the favorite of any of these gymnasts here today in England. It has been a struggle. No exception for Kajita. 11.366 at the bottom of the standings. So Aliya Mustafina, the Russian, also had trouble on the beam, but with so many others experiencing difficulty as well, she's able to hold on to the lead after three rotations with just the floor left to go here in Birmingham today. Coming up on April the 7th, it's the World Cup from Tokyo, the host city for the Olympic Games in 2020, hosting the World Cup in just a few weeks' time. Both the women's and the men's all around on the Olympic Channel. And headed to the final rotation today in Birmingham, England, it's the seven-time Olympic medalist, Aliya Mustafina, leading the American Riley McCusker. in the top two spots in the standings. Just the floor left to go.
Our next competitor on the
this
floor,
will decide it. And coming up
Great
first,
Britain.
It's Ellie Downey of Great Britain performing here today at home. But this was back in Rio in 2016 on the floor during qualification. Hard and scary fall.
And if you think that gymnasts aren't tough, that is a visual example of just how fearless they can be. She came back later in the Olympics to show everybody I'm okay and I can do this.
Now the native of Nottingham in front of the home fans today in England.
Had that very disappointing uneven bars. She can be great here.
Fell off the bars twice earlier today, so we're really hoping to finish with a flourish now.
More like the Ellie Downey we have grown accustomed to seeing. A big floor routine to close out today's championships for her. Super difficult first tumbling run. Full and half twist right through to an Arabian double front. So hard to stay in bounds on that. Definitely has a lot of gymnastics left in her. Very powerful. Doesn't even have to grab her legs on that double back somersault. You know, she wasn't at her best here, certainly, but she has a very bright future, as I have said, as does Team GBR. They've had a lot of injuries on their squad. Many are getting healthy again, and they can be a factor.
And she's no exception, an ankle injury herself last year. With the European all-around champion from 2017 performing at home in front of the English fans today in a score of 13.033 on the floor. We are just underway in the floor routine, final of the four rotations in Birmingham, England.
Floor, representing Germany, Leah Grieser.
Leah Grieser of Germany up next. The final two will be the American Riley McCusker as well as the Russian Alia Mustafina. The top two after three rotations, where Mustafina has a lead of almost a full point.
Thank you.
Well, this is more like it. Very nice routine, well executed. Looks like she enjoys herself. That comes through with the choreography. Couple of really nice elements in that routine. A beautiful double turn into what's called an illusion. But really feeling the music and performing exactly what the judges are looking for. That's actually a requirement, the artistic component on floor exercise.
2.5 twists, just a step to control it.
Now she is the German national champion on the floor from 2018.
Every gymnast has unique choreography.
Also helped Germany qualify for the Olympics as a team when they finished second in the team event at the 2016 Olympic test event. She was third in the floor exercise during that competition, but was not selected to compete at the Olympic Games themselves in Rio.
That's brutal. She helped get them there, yeah. And she doesn't get to go. She's not the only one that that happened to, though. There were many gymnasts that faced that same fate, but really nice finish of the competition for this young lady right here.
It's hardly rare. It happens at every Olympics, but boy, it is brutal. I mean, you help get your nation there. Figure that should at least
mean something.
Right, get you some currency, get you some street cred out there, but she was left behind. For some, it could be crushing. For others, it can motivate them towards the next Olympics. And now here is Victoria Wu of Canada, the 21-year-old from Quebec, up next on the floor.
Another great floor exercise routine. Really good tumbling. The mount, double layout, just awesome. Great finish at the end as well. Really powerful start to the routine. Keeps her body completely stretched, laid out, which makes it very difficult to get two flips around. Fell out of that a little bit. But had another major turning element. Check that out. A little dizzy. How about you, Steve?
A little vertigo setting in.
Required to do that front flip. Another routine where you can tell she actually enjoys the choreography and the dance as well. But look at that. Just rock solid double pike to near perfection on the landing.
Well, along with her younger sister Rose, both have competed on the Canadian national team. That's the older of the two Woos here today in Birmingham. Finishing off
awesome.
Her day of work.
Thank you.
Quebec native, catching her breath as she waits for the marks.
Yeah, Beam was, as we've said, somewhat horrific, but Floor so far has made it worthwhile to wait.
12.8 for the Canadian. Well, our last gymnast of the day will be Aliyah Mustafina, leader after three rotations, bronze medalist from the Olympics 2012. She's still to come as we continue. Thais Fidelis of Brazil, the first of the final four in Birmingham. As we get set to
and
close things out.
On floor, representing Brazil, Thais Fidelis.
Again, the final two will be the American Riley McCusker and then Aliyah Mustafina to decide the overall champion. Mustafina with a lead of almost a full point coming into this final rotation.
And this is her best event, 2017 Worlds. She was fourth on floor exercise. Very intricate tumbling run, the same we saw from Ellie Downey. Oh boy, I think she was out of bounds with both feet.
After she just missed a medal at those World Championships in Montreal, she said prior to last year's Worlds that it made her dream about being in other finals, being in the Olympics, about finally getting that elusive medal.
Very nice. Only 17 years old, was not eligible to compete in 2016 at home in Rio for the Olympics. Was too young. And I believe the left foot was out of bounds initially, and then when she jumps, the right went out as well. 1/10 for one. Foot out of bounds, 3 for both. But beyond that, this was very nice routine. Very powerful athlete, as you can see. I think she just needs to believe in herself a little bit more on the road to Tokyo. She's certainly capable of doing a bigger vault than she showed today. The Brazil team has a number of veterans, and they need young athletes like her to step up and put pressure on the veterans. It'll make everybody better.
And her score, 13.1. So she's just the leader for the moment, but the top three after the first three rotations are coming up with Caroline Adouet of France up first, and then it's the American Riley McCusker, and then Mustafina to finish things off.
her hit routine right here. Tumbling was all landed very well. Got a little bit wild on one of her turns in the routine. This very difficult. She does a what's called a whip back into that double back, so she flips and doesn't put her hands down. Nice double pike right there. Needs to work on the landings, show a little more control. This is where she kind of fell out of that turn right there. Good recovery. Really wasn't in a great position to rebound for that front flip, but deals with it well. Once again, only 15 years old. So she is a newbie and an up-and-comer for the up-and-coming French team.
Yeah, last year at the European Junior Championships was on the podium. So certainly a bright future for the young French woman from the south of France. 12.7 her score. And when we come back, it's Riley McCusker of the U.S. for the final time in her season debut here at the World Cup in Birmingham, England.
Representing the United States of America, Riley McCusker.
The 17-year-old from New Jersey, again in her season debut here in England. Last year, third in the all-around at the U.S. National Championships. And in second place coming into this final rotation here in Birmingham.
Well, she's got to be great, and Mustafina's got to open the door for her.
Tim Daggett.
Well, she certainly didn't have a major error. She's going to need Aliyah Mustafina to make a major mistake. But I'll tell you what. This is the top of the routine. Really the only major error. And it's not major. It's just significant. The landing on that full in. This was great. Double full forwards into a front and then a leap. But I'll tell you what. It is exhausting to tumble, but when you dance with all the energy and the effort that she does, this is exhausting. And it's really appreciated by the judges, certainly. She shows off everything, goes to the max with all of the positions, knees always perfectly straight, toes pointed, nearly to the point of cramping. Exhausting to perform a routine like this, but I'd expect nothing less from Riley McCusker.
Not just finishing her junior year of high school. She is homeschooled and plans to compete at the University of Florida. So headed to Gainesville to be a Gator. And 13.366 her score in England. So she's the leader with
stuff in him. The last to go.
And there she is, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it. Representing the Russian Federation, give it up for Alia Mustafina.
She has earned a world championship medal in every event, including two on the floor, where she's also the bronze medalist from the Olympic Games in London in 2012. And now going for the win in the same country on the World Cup here today in Birmingham. Mistake from Alia, and she did not oblige. There is your champion from 1 week ago. She was fifth place in Stuttgart. But here is the champion. And she looks considerably better here than she did just 1 week before.
Yeah, sure. Her only weakness really was on the beam, but other than that, the other three rotations, extremely strong.
And that is new for her lately, that full twisting double somersault. Did an Arabian double front last week. Second pass, very powerful double back somersault. She has been a factor on the world scene for so long, and not just in one area. All the events and the all-around. Could she go to her third Olympic Games and win multiple medals again for Team Russia? Wow, what a career. And it's not over.
Now, after a fifth-place finish in the all-around last week, where she was third on every apparatus except the beam, where she really struggled, she also struggled on the beam again here today in Birmingham, but robust in the other rotations to get the victory. Score on floor just shy of 13.
And a great event for her, certainly. Also for Riley, she had two major errors, though. You compare this, though, to the greatest of all time. Last week, Alia was fifth in the all-around. The champ was Simone Biles with nearly 59 points, which is ginormous.
So that'll do it for this World Cup stop in Birmingham. Riley McCusker starting her season and trying to build upon a resurgent 2018, but finishes in second place as she could not get by the 24-year-old Russian. As it is Mustafina, headed towards Tokyo, trying to add to her career haul of 7 Olympic medals. And now for Tim Dagen, I'm Steve Schlanger. Thanks for watching the women's gymnastics from Birmingham, England.